Hi, it's Kevin LeBates here, and for fun, over the last couple of days I've been looking at the Chia blockchain. It's taken me a while to get around to it. It's an interesting one. It was put forward and developed and designed by the inventor of BitTorrent, and its main aim is to overcome the problem of proof-of-work systems such as used in Bitcoin, where you are burning vast amounts of electricity by all reports in order to perform billions upon billions of calculations per second to secure the network, i.e. the energy is just burnt and wasted, except it's not wasted, it's spent to secure the network. That's the purpose of it. But anyway, energy consumption of Bitcoin aside, the idea behind Bram's Chia network is that instead of using proof of work, i.e. work which is energy, you have proof of space. And the space in this case is not land, as you can see all around me here in the forest. The space is on hard drives, but there's a nice analogy with it. A bigger hard drive is like a bigger plot of land. And so what the fundamental idea behind the system is that your expenditure is on buying hard drives, and you fill these hard drives up with junk. So instead of burning energy on pointless calculations, you're wasting hard drive space on fundamentally pointless data, just to prove that you have spent so many $100 on a hard drive and are not using it for anything else other than securing the network. And they use this farming analogy where the files that are stored on the hard drives are called plots. It's like a farmer and you farm these plots. But the practical thing is that having a hard drive sitting there, not doing very much most of the time, only occasionally being queried to prove that you do actually have masses of these files wasting all your disk space, that's showing that you've put skin in the game, that you've spent money on this hardware. And unlike an ASIC miner or a GPU, you're not constantly burning vast quantities of energy in order to do calculations. It's just sitting there passively, except for the few occasions where it has to spring to life in order to retrieve some data to prove that you genuinely have not used the drive for anything else. The upshot of this apparently has been that firstly, the cost of hard drives went up, or rather there was a shortage in the supply chain for them. We're seeing cryptocurrencies doing this to computing hardware on a regular basis now. Graphics cards are apparently quite hard to come by these days as well due to crypto mining. The second upshot has been that it turns out all the disk writes to these disks causes them to fail a lot earlier in their life than they normally would. And this is particularly harsh on solid state drives rather than traditional magnetic hard drives. So like all things in life, you think you have a good idea, you think that you've pushed the bubble down on the wallpaper on one part of the wall, but of course it always pops up somewhere else. I can't help thinking that this is more evidence of the fundamental fact that if you're going to create a virtual store of value, a digital gold as it were, there is always going to be a cost. And it's a bit like the conservation of energy, that no matter how much you try to save in one area, you end up paying in another one. Anyway, we'll see how Chia goes. Maybe it has managed to break some fundamental laws of energy as seen as analogies in this digital space, because of course the analogy between the physical world and the digital world is not perfect, and there are all sorts of things that we don't fully understand. I guess it's just a matter of waiting and seeing. In the meantime, I have a couple of hard drives filling up with junk. I'll let you know sometime later how it all panned out. Bye for now.